ladies and gentlemen, for the thousands joining us live and the millions joining us around the world, it's time to meet the players. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome from England, the winner of 10 Women's Series titles, the reigning Women's World Match Play Champion, a Grand Slam quarter-finalist, the Nordic Darts Masters finalist, who, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alexandra Palace, the Queen of the Palace, Paloma Sherrod! Gentlemen from England, taking part in his 8th World Championship, the fastest player in the world, it's Robin Ricky
to get the crowd back behind you, isn't it? He's still going. Wow, they booed him at the start and the song came on. He was dressed as Santa and he's loving every single minute of it. So are they, by the way. Yeah, I think even the Fallon fans out there are now behind Ricky Evans. He did throw that beard straight into the crowd. Look at this guy. Oh, wow. Ricky Evans. Known as Rapid Ricky Evans. Oh, he's warmed up already, isn't he? Yeah, cheeky little handshake. Ricky Evans making an 8th World Championship appearance. Made it past this stage the last 3 years running. How will he get on this time around, though? Up against the Queen of the Palace, who walked out to some support here until that. But she has plenty of support here, down really to her heroics up on that famous stage 3 years ago. Fallon with that fairy tale run, beating Ted Everts and then Mincer Sulevic. She even had Bibi Jean King tweeting about her. Right, let's hand you over to comms for what should be a cracking first round tie. Here's Laura Turner and Rod Studd.
Thank you, Emma. Good evening. Yes, it was 3 years and 3 days ago that Fallon Sherrod made history. The 17th of December 2019, when she beat Ted Evets, she went on to beat Mensah Sulevic, the then world number 11, before losing to Chris Dobie. And tonight she aims to start making history again on her stage against Catherine Speedster Ricky Evans. And that's a high-octane start from Fallon Sherrod, with the first matchman in the match. With the second visit of the match, Ricky Evans came on disguised as Santa Claus. He's now revealed as a serious darts player up on the stage. And the question is, Laura Turner, can Fallon Sherrod make history again tonight?
Well, I think it's possible. I think, as Mark said, it's going to be all of them this first set. Whoever gets that quick start comes out the tracks. I mean, they both come out very well, but it's whoever finishes off well. But both settled very quickly.
Ricky, you've got 160.
So Ricky Evans can't take out the big finish. Cameron Menzies watching his partner Fallon Sherrick play. We've already seen Cammy in action. Tops for Fallon.
Second. Ricky Rivard, 64.
Another. Oh, double eight off the accidental double 16.
Fallon Rivard, 20.
Double 10. Double five.
15. Ricky require eight.
Well, it all started smoothly, but it's got scrappy. And Evans puts an end to it.
Second leg for Ricky to throw first.
Kind of as we were saying at, just before the match, one of the elements of Fallon's game, which I think has kind of let her down over the last 6 to 12 months, has been her finishing. When you compare it to the stats that she produced here when she went on that epic run, that history-making run, they are just not in the same ballpark at the moment.
Yeah, finishing in that World Championship run in 2019 was absolutely ace, wasn't it?
Oh, 86.
Absolutely world-class. And it just carried on throughout the three games, really. Even against Doby, she was finishing beautifully, and in the end, he was just too strong for her.
Yeah, I think, yeah, as you say, even after that game, she was still over 50% on checkouts, peaking at 69% when she beat Mensa Sulovic.
And for a few days at least, in and around Christmas 2019, Fallon Sherrick was the most famous darts player in the world, bar none. As Emma was saying, Billie Jean King 70. Enlisted herself in the Fallon Sherrick fan club, and she was on every media outlet all over the United Kingdom in the day and days after that win 70. Over Ted Evans. You named the channel, the programme, and Fallon Sherrick was on it.
Yeah, I think it was a reaction that took all of us by surprise, but probably none more than Fallon herself.
And really, from someone that we knew as a shy young woman from Milton Keynes, she handled all that superbly. She took it all in a stride, didn't she? In a completely alien environment to her.
And full required. Oh, and that would have been for a break straight back. Yeah, absolutely, like you say. You think the day after she won, she was up at like 6 o'clock on Good Morning Britain or whatever it was with Piers Morgan at the time.
Double eight. And this is more her home environment, if you will, up on the stage at the Alexandra Palace. More her comfort zone, and she showed it there by hitting her first double of the match. We saw four missed in the first leg by Fallon Sherrick, but she tied it up there.
80. Six.
It's quite interesting to hear Fallon talk about the build-up to this. Obviously, you know, she won the women's match play. She finished third overall in the women's series when she got the invitation, obviously, to participate. Just the cherry on the, you know, the icing on the cake. But she's recognised that she's played a lot competitively but hasn't put in quite enough practice. That's where I think, you know, she spent the last few weeks just really knuckling down and focusing, especially on the finishing end of her game.
Oh, 140.
This is another good leg from Sherrick here. 12 darts thrown, 36 points left, double 18 to go in front for the first time in the contest. Double 18 was the double of the history-making double, but double 9 will do just as well. A nice little 14-dart leg, and she's recovered from losing the first leg to take the lead in the opening set now. So Evans has got some work to do. It started well after he took advantage of some missed darts at double by Sherrick. But since then, it's been downhill for the high-speed dartist.
Mark pointed out both these players possibly not being as consistent as possible and are lacking that bit of confidence.
Yeah, there was a lot of hullabaloo about Fallon Sherrick's enclosure in the tournament, but that, in the end, has got nothing to do with her law, has it? Professional sportsmen and sportswomen turn up to play, and they don't get involved in the circus and the nonsense that goes on around art, people arguing on social media. That's, she couldn't care less about that right now. She's just trying to win a professional darts match.
Yeah, totally agree.
And so is Ricky Evans, mind you. And he's in a match here, Evans, for sure.
Strong visit, but need treble 19. And just off the mark, so Fallon back for 66.
We'll get one dart at double 18. That was for the first set. And Ricky Evans now will not want Sherrick coming back for the same target, so needs to mop up this 70 on double 16 at the end of a three-dart combination. And Ricky Evans, rapid Ricky, slowed himself right down to a snail's pace there and still missed the double. And Fallon Sherrick is in again at the Alexandra Palace. The Queen of the Palace has taken the first set off Ricky Evans as she bears. Just looking at some of the data that they collect these days, Evans is no longer the fastest thrower in the world. That accolade currently belongs to Jermaine Wataminah, who was throwing at the last Players' Championship at 4.79 seconds a visit. Keane Barry was second, and Evans in a slow coach, 5.38 seconds a visit. So far at the Worlds, Michael Smith leading the way at 5.47 in his win over Nathan Rafferty. So Evans is going to have to get a shift on to challenge that. But what he's really worried about now is not the speed his darts are going in, it's where they're going.
134. Visit firmly putting Sherrick into the driving seat quite early on in this second set. You can just see from Ricky's body language, he's not happy, he's not finding the scores.
No, he's currently struggling and he's being outplayed by Fallon Sherrick.
107.
Well, the maximum finish, but not this time.
94. 58. 76.
So, big opportunity here for an early breaker throw for Sherrick. We're looking at 20. Over for 36. Yeah, excellently taken there from Fallon Sherrick. Ricky Evans is in a spot of bother.
Yeah, this is becoming a dominant display from the Women's World Match Play champion. You mentioned, Laura, that it had been a broadly disappointing year, I think, for Fallon Sherrick, and I think she would probably agree with that sentiment, but the Women's World Match Play was still a very big win for her. It was the inaugural tournament, as you know, and you enjoyed it yourself, competing in it, and it was big for her to win that because, as Phil Taylor used to say, they can do what they like after the first one. I'll always be the first to win X, Y, or Z, whatever it was, and he set great store on that.
No, I totally agree. I was proud enough just to be a part of the first one. And talking of first ones, that is the first 180 there, which goes to Ricky Evans.
Yeah,
Jambo winning that match play as well. Obviously had to overcome some really tough challenges and beat Aileen de Graaf in the final.
At least the bullseye for Ricky Evans, and bingo! In the blink of an eye, Ricky Evans hits the button and levels up the set, and that might be the lighting of the blue touch paper for Ricky Evans. And a smile of, no doubt, inner disappointment for Fallon Sherrett. But in darts, you just have to take it on the chin quite often, Laura, don't you? You know, if your opponent just knocks in a big one like that, you just have to smile and nod, because you know it can happen. You don't want it to happen. You, obviously, you sit up there with the best one in the world hoping your opponent misses, but when they don't, you just have to smile and take the blow and ride it out.
Yeah, absolutely, and then just hope that you can do it to them next time so they know exactly how it feels.
68.
Yeah, and you wonder if that's the leg that's going to spark Ricky Evans into life in this match. But Fallon Sherrett back again. And there's her second 180 of the match.
Yeah, Ricky Evans has been in worse strife than this at the World Championship. Back in 2016, he was two sets down and two legs down to Simon Whitlock in a race to three sets, but managed to get home 3-2, winning in a tiebreaker.
56, Ricky Uruguayan, 99.
So there'll be no panic at this stage for Ricky Evans. Went tops, 59. Found two singles to leave tops, 25. If he comes back. Missed the big nine, 11 going now. Three for double four, you would think. That was close to the treble.
17.
But she misses double four, so bit of a mess, and Evans cleans up. Yeah, the kind of mistake that at this level usually gets punished more often than not.
Yeah, and I think more than that big outshot, that would be more frustrating for Fallon, because she had herself in such a good position to break straight back again. You could see the relief on Evans' face.
These 25s are becoming a bit of a hobby horse than mine. I was saying to John Park the other day, I can't understand why players don't practice 25 more often. It comes up so often. And I liken it to the snooker players mopping up the colours. It happens so often. They clean up yellow through to black and they practice it over and over again. But darts players tend to say they don't specifically practice 25. You practice 25?
No.
You'll be on my hit list.
No,
John Park's already on it, Laura, so you're in very good company.
Thanks very much. You might have a point. Perhaps I should.
It's just such a common thing, isn't it? We may have another bull attempt at the end of this. Fallon Sherrett will hope so, but she needs to find the two big trebles first and foremost, and she can't do so.
95.
No, but she'll be back. Evans all the way back on 286.
96. Fallon Uruguayan, 66.
20 will leave her double 18 again.
48.
Well, back for the awkward double 9, which would level up this set and send it into a fifth and deciding leg.
Fallon Uruguayan, 18.
Now this could start to get awkward. But she ensures it does not get awkward by finishing off a very important leg. And now, Laura, one of these fifth legs in a set. We know they're so important, so pivotal.
Yeah, and that is the perfect start there for Ricky Evans in this fifth leg of the second set.
We knew it was important, and so did the two players.
I thought, and I think everyone thought, I think Fallon thought that was coming back with a 180.
Yes.
But a really loose visit there from Ricky Evans as he salutes the crowd.
Yeah, not exactly the ideal back up to his maximum. Now, in the next 90 seconds or so, Sherrett will either be 2-0 up or Evans will have levelled at 1-1 in sets. That's the importance of the next few visits to this board. Oh, Evans now flowing.
140.
Two big trebles, an absolute must.
97, Ricky to 155.
Evans' advantage here.
97, value to 164.
Ricky Evans now, courtesy of a very, very high quality leg of scoring, has got himself a two dart combination after a dozen darts to level up the match. Finds the single 18. It was close to the one, and that might have just disturbed him a touch. Now double 10. And he misses two at double, having slowed his game down again. But I just wonder, was he disturbed, Laura, by the unconvincing single?
Yeah, perhaps. Treble required here for Fallon, but Ricky will be back. I think maybe he fumbled his dart slightly.
Okay, and he's got another three at a double. And the second one finds the target, and Ricky Evans looks to build the applause, but there isn't much coming back at you, Ricky, but he is level in this match. Good set by Evans, to be fair. Deservedly back on level terms. It's Ricky Evans 1, Fallon Sherrick 1 at the Abbey Pally. But a lot to be done before then in this match.
In terms of scoring statistics, Fallon is outscoring Ricky Evans at the moment in all areas. As I say, it's the doubles, the attempts at doubles, 5 out of 18 compared to 4 from 9 for Ricky Evans.
96.
Another treble before the switch. There it is.
132.
Very nice visit from 3-2 to lead tops. That loose opening dart means no finish, and so Ricky Evans now can continue his good run by taking another leg here on tops. Double 10. 14 dart leg. Very good. Ricky Evans really starting to motor now. People like to look at the break and players leaving the stage as some kind of break of patterns of play, but Evans has just come back out and carried on doing what he was doing before, hasn't he?
Well, you could argue in the other way that he came back after the first break and actually did something completely different. I think that we perhaps look into it slightly too much, to be fair. We like a narrative, Rod. That's what it is.
Oh yeah, of course. People asking for Wayne Mardell's shirt. He's got a rather dowdy number on tonight, hasn't he, Wayne? He's not really in his normal flamboyant garb this evening. I presume the request was one of those Hawaiian numbers.
134.
That's nice. And Evans trumps it with another maximum. That's his third of the match to leave 83 after 12 darts. So a 14 darter could be followed by another 14 darter. But wait, oh, have a look at the bullseye here.
137.
Good effort. But wide of the mark, or too high above the mark, in fact, in the end. And now Ricky Evans missed the treble 16 or the single, and he'll be disappointed with that because now he's given Sherrick a chance. Double 15. Oh, it's all happening here at Alexandra Palace as Sherrick bangs in a 13 dart leg to level the set. Almost took out the big finish on the ball, but then was cool on the double 15. This is good stuff now, Laura, isn't it?
Yeah, excellent period of play here.
Shades of 2019 there on the finishing.
So they are the opportunity she's going to have to take. You can hear the Ali Pally in full voice.
Well, I'm sure Fallon Sherrick feels that this is her stage. And she's just loaning part of it for a few minutes to Ricky Evans to take part in the match. This is a stage on which she's extremely comfortable, we know that. The darling of the Alexandra Palace crowd. And whoever you are, it's a great thrill to have people singing your name, isn't it? And she knows they've all come to see her play, and that's a wonderful feeling for any sportsman or woman.
76.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a feeling you just can't replicate anywhere else barring sports. I suppose, you know, Robbie Williams gets it when he's on stage at Glastonbury and things like that, you know, the great musicians and singers. But sport and music are about the only two places you can get that kind of buzz.
It's just, it's adulation, it's enjoyment, you're entertaining them, it's everything, isn't it? And I guess when you get that, what you want to do is be able to put in a performance for them. And these two most definitely are. He's double 16.
30.
No finish for Rapid Ricky, who really has been turning on the style himself. Full credit, the second set and the start of the third was Vintage Evans. If you can have vintage when you're only 32 years old. Sherrick wants this double 16. And there it is. And she now takes the lead in this set. Almost at the halfway house of the match, if you like. The midway point, the third of five possible sets.
Visibly not happy with that. Ideally would like to try and tie up this set, but Ricky's having none of it.
This has the air of a very close contest, which has been on a knife edge for a few minutes and could shift in direction at any tick of the clock with some brilliant finishing or maybe a clutch of missed darts at double by one or either of the two players.
I agree. Yeah, and an excellent visit there to a set of a 1-6-7. Sherrick first to a finish, but Ricky in a good position to leave a better one.
To leave 24. This is brilliant from Evans. Absolutely superb. A dozen darts to leave two dozen. And Ricky Evans now, we just saw a couple of legs ago, a 13 darter from Fallon Sherrick. Ricky Evans trying to match that. And matching he has. Brilliant darts from Ricky Evans. And he sends it again into a fifth and final leg. Now, in the previous set, the second set, Evans won the last leg, the fifth leg, to level the match. And at this moment in time, bookmakers prefer the chance of Evans making him 6-4 on to win with Sherrick 11-10, but not much in it. And this leg will shift those odds quite considerably. Either way.
120.
Sherrick has the darts, but Evans's big start there has probably taken them off her.
430. Sherrick really is making good use of the switch down to the 19. She's adjusted on a few occasions. Really making the most of it. And a wild one there from Ricky Evans.
Sherrick now back in front in the leg in terms of having the darts, because started his visit just a dozen behind and should move into the lead quite considerably. She might have hoped for another treble there, if she would have done, but even so, Evans will need to hit two. It's one of those legs now when you're just looking at every dart, knowing that every dart is making a difference, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's going to be just down to who can keep composed, who can hold it all together, and who can hit that winning double. And another good, steady visit there from Fallon Sherrick. Down to 1-1-2 after 12.
The winner of this leg will be 2-1 in front, and the loser of this leg will have to win two consecutive sets to win the match. That's the difference it will make. And there'll be a dart for the set here. And it will be at tops for Fallon Sherrick.
92.
Now she's banking on coming back. And she will be. Can she take it to the bank now on double 10? Taking all the time in the world as the crowd get onto their feet. double five. And that could be an error that's fatal in this set. His three darts came and went then, and another in the visit before. Evans wants tops. Rapid Ricky has turned into the snail. But he won't care if he hits the double. It doesn't matter how quickly he gets there. But he's got to get there, Ricky. Oh, that's a double she doesn't want. She's got to get another. Oh, my goodness me. What's going on here? Now, tops. And Ricky Evans ends the fun. At the end of that set, Ricky Evans now is in front in sets, and Fallon Sherratt will know that that was an opportunity spurned. He'd missed a couple himself at double, but when he got another chance, he took it. But Fallon Sherratt there, Laura, was making mistakes, the like of which that we didn't see at all in 2019.
A huge, huge opportunity got missing there for Fallon Sherratt. And it's interesting, the end of all three sets, Ricky Evans has taken that pause and it hasn't panned out for him. I know he was kind of experimenting with throwing that little bit slower, but he himself said it's not him. It's not how he does it.
I'm not even sure why he's doing that at all.
And it's just at the tail end of the sets that I've noticed.
Something strange had gone through his mind to make that tactical decision to throw slower. When he's known as a guy who throws at high speed, as I've mentioned before, Rapid Ricky with his 5 seconds for three darts kind of average. And we see him as a player that's all about the rhythm.
Well, yeah, you were talking about the kind of stats that we get now. I think he holds the record for the first as 180 here in 2.16 seconds.
Incredible. But he chose to break his own rhythm. But in the end, it hasn't mattered, has it? In the sense that he still won the leg and won the set, despite all that.
Of course, but he did get lucky in that process.
He did, yes. He needed to take advantage of Fallon Sherratt missing those four darts at a double and then getting in an awful pickle, busting her score when she was ending up trying to go 1-1.
Strong start again from Sherratt in this fourth set. 43. This must-win set for Fallon Sherratt. Stay there for another 20 for double 18. Yeah, very, very solid stuff from Sherratt. And she's starting off the sets well. It's just that business end.
Yeah. And that was a break of the Evans throw in a set that she has to break his throw overall to take it and level it up and send it all the way into a fifth and final set. At the moment, it's still advantage Ricky Evans. In periods, he's been good Evans, but not consistently so, has he? I mean, he's made mistakes himself, and he knows that. But overall, you have to give him some credit because he's done well to get himself back into a game, which he was trailing early on, wasn't he? And the last couple of sets, he looked like losing either or both of those, but he didn't. He won them both.
As we've said previously, the key thing is winning. It doesn't matter how you do it. The key thing is winning.
And he sped up there and really tried to break that land speed record on the 180s that you were just alluding to, Laura. He's looking to pop one in under 2 seconds, I think. The third one sort of reached the board almost before the second had reached it itself. It was incredible.
It's almost like he hasn't quite settled into a pace, into a rhythm. And that's something that can happen when you're not feeling quite as confident, when you have struggled with consistency.
There have been times over the past few years when Evans was throwing it his absolute quickest, when it almost seemed that the three darts were in flight at the same time.
138.
It couldn't have been, of course, but sometimes it looked like he was managed to throw darts 1, 2, and 3 almost at the same time. And here, the 90 leaves him 52, which is the score that Sherratt is on. That leaves double 8.
Yes, on the second leg, Fallon Sherratt. The Ricky to throw first. Game.
And Sherratt putting all ideas of spurned opportunities behind her is 100% for doubles in this set, this must-win set.
Now, there's a danger that we as observers can get ahead of ourselves. That's something that players must avoid. So I'm sure Fallon Sherratt won't be thinking that I'm thinking here. What I'm thinking now is, now in the final set, and because I've almost thought she's going to win this from 2-0, she will have the darts, which is a massive thing when there's no tiebreak in this round one tie.
Absolutely, absolutely. But we can see how quickly it can change. Just look at Richie Edhouse last night against Dave Cameron. Was two sets up, 2-0 up, and Cameron fought all the way back for a win. So we know how quickly these tides can turn.
Yes, I should learn by now not to assume a player two legs up in a set will win it, because we have seen many, many times, as you just pointed out, Laura, that it's not necessarily the case. But nevertheless, Sherratt here has got herself to within a couple of visits of winning the set.
And the lack of treble there from Evans opens the door here for Sherratt to set something up.
Ricky Rigol, 160.
Two treble 20s, the target for double 20.
28.
But once the finish was out of the equation, that was as good as it could get. Evans here to halve the deficit in the set, and he has done. Emphatic stuff. It was a 16 dart leg from Rapid Ricky. 2-1 now. So Fallon Sherratt with the darts in this fourth leg and wants to make this the last leg of the set. Needs a holder throw here, wrap the set up, get on with it, get on with the next set. Doesn't want to give Ricky Evans any kind of glimmer of hope. Just shut the door on him in this set and get on to the next.
83.
Yeah, that's a good last start from Fallon. And this kind of goes back to the psychology and that idea of being two sets up as a player, not letting you get run away, you know, run away with you. But now Fallon's just found herself, she's one break away from then having to exit the tournament.
Yeah. If she loses her throw here, she's back in trouble because Evans has the darts at the end of this set. Yeah, getting ahead of yourself in any sport is very dangerous, but in darts particularly so. You can only throw the next dart in your hand. That's the only one you can really affect anything with at the moment.
And again for Sherratt, that last dart just saving her.
Evans here has found exactly what he was looking for. That is a fifth maximum.
Yeah, that's all he could do. Couldn't leave a finish.
83.
I couldn't leave a finish, but he certainly can now, Laura, can't he?
Absolutely.
And it could be something very manageable.
89. 118.
Two darter for Ricky. No finish for Fallon.
80, Ricky Rigol, 74.
Well, we often talk about timing. 32 required here.
Sharp intake of breath and the wrong double. That's what he'll be coming back for if Sherratt does not take out 38. Will she go straight for double 19? She will, but she's missed it. Three for double 8. Last dart in hand. That was for the set. She knows just how important that was, and so does Cammy Menzies. Ricky Evans hits the target that Sherratt could not find, and Ricky Evans, a full credit to him. The set looked done, he's got it back to 2-2, and now, most importantly, Ricky Evans has the darts to wrap this up. This has been a really tough tussle, one that has seesawed one way then the other, but in the end now, Ricky Evans has the match in the palm of his hand.
25.
And now after that, it's just a question of Evans keeping darts straight, isn't it? Now, the odd treble, but just avoiding mistakes going into 1 and 5. Six. Even visits of 60 will nudge him down towards the line unless Fallon starts producing maximums.
Yeah, was not the start she's looking for, and not the follow-up either. And it has been a case of missed opportunities, unfortunately, in these sets for Fallon Sherratt.
60.
Ricky Evans has just stepped in when the opportunity has been presented.
It's been warm work and hard work, though, for Ricky Evans, as you saw there.
20 bar.
Well, another treble 20 would have just changed the mood music once more.
134.
Sherrick unable to leave a finisher, Ricky back.
That's good enough. And now double 16 for a 107 finish to defeat the Queen of the Palace on a return to the Ali Pali stage. She threatened to make more history 3 years on for that epic win over Ted Evans. But in the end, Ricky Evans was just too strong. He hung on in there when the going got tough. And did enough to win the game by 3 sets to 1. So Rick.